Now here, what you have to write? Select star from table name, where condition. Now I want to select this third record from the table. So how to write now here with the help of where clause? You have to write after table name. Anyone? Yes. Where? What you have to select now? Either asset ID or comments. You can write any field name. So here I'll write asset ID. As you can see here, A capital is there, even ID is capital. So write down same as it is, how it is there. If I'll do any mistake in spellings, instead of writing capital, if I'll written small, also it will gives you the error. It will not gives you the answer. So write down assets ID is equal to, I want to fetch only this third record from this table. So I'll write asset ID is equal to 3. And that you have to write in single quote. After that, don't forget to give semicolon. Add here semicolon. Just click on this symbol or else press F5. You will get only this third record from the table. So you all understood about the where clause?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now,
press
F5 from your keyboard. Function F5.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Next, we will see order by clause. As I told you, what is the use of order by clause? If you want to find out, take the data in sorting list, if you want to take the data, if you want to insert the data in ascending or descending order, then you are going to use order by clause. As in your textbook from page number 241, order by clause syntax is there. What is the syntax of your order by clause? Select star from table name, order by condition. So what is my table name here now? I want to take this assets ID in ascending order. So syntax of your asset order by clause is what? Select star from table name, order by condition. So how to write this now? How to write this now? Select star from table name is what? Assets. After that, what you have to write?
Order by
where?
We have to write where in order by clause?
No, ma'am.
Then what do we have to write?
Order by.
Order by condition. Okay. Either this you can write in capital or else small. If you want to write capital also, you can write in capital. Okay. So I want to take this asset ID in means ascending order. So how to write this now? How to write this now? Order by assets ID. See the spellings. Okay, A-S-S-E-T it is. Asset ID, write down in double quote, is equal to asset ID. Either you can write is equal to or else, if I'll not write also okay. So I want this asset ID in ascending order.
Ma'am, asset ID spelling is wrong.
Yes. Okay, so now it is correct. Okay. Asset ID, I want this in ascending order. So for ascending, you have to use ASC. For descending, you have to use DESC, the short form. So right here, ASC, give a semicolon. And next, press this symbol or else press F5. It is giving you this asset ID in ascending order. Okay, from 1, 2, 3. Now, if I want that asset ID in descending order, then what you have to write? You have to write in, that is in DESC. DESC. If you want in ascending, ASC. If you want that in descending, DESC, you have to write. Press F5. You will get this in descending order. If you want comments in ascending and descending order, only thing is that you have to change this field name. So here you have to change this field name. Instead of asset ID, I want comments in descending order. So just write the spelling correctly. I'll write your comments in descending. press this. You will get these comments in descending order. If you want this in ascending order, then you just write here ASC in capital. Press F5. You will get this in ascending order. Is that clear? Order by clause. Everyone understood how to write?
Ma'am, no.
Yes, which doubt you have?
Ma'am, if we want the second, first and the third, second, like that, what we have to do?
Only third one. Only third one if you want.
Ma'am, no.
Not only third one, shuffled like nice is at first.
No, it will give only... Only it will give ascending and descending order. It will not give the shuffle order. Okay?
Okay.
It will give either ascending or else descending. It will not give you the shuffling. Means like 1, 3 and 2. It will not give like that. Only order by clause is used for the purpose of ascending and descending order. Not in shuffling order. Understood or no? Any doubt in order by clause?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Next, we will see your second query, that is insert query. What is the use of insert query? Suppose now I inserted here only 3 records while creating the table. But sometimes after creating the table, if I want to add too many records, then that time I didn't I will not create one more time the table and edit in that. So instead of that, with the help of query only, we can insert too many records in the same table. So that time we are using insert query. So what is the use of insert query? If you want to add the record, if you want to insert the records, that time we are going to use the insert query. As you know the syntax of your insert query, that is insert into your table name. Then you are writing the field name and values. As you can see on your page number 238, the syntax is there. Insert into table name in brackets. You are writing the different fields and you are writing the values, which values you have to insert. Just minimize this. Go to your first page of your OpenOffice. Click on your queries. You have to run insert query from tools option. So just click on your tools option. From tools, you have to select SQL and that insert query you have to execute here. If you'll execute on this create query in SQL view, it will not give you the result. It will give you the error. So whenever you are executing insert, delete and update query, you have to execute on this SQL command. So you have to write now insert query. Now, already 3 records are there in my table. I want to record 4th record in my table. So for that purpose, I'm using this insert query. As you all know, already the syntax of your insert query, that is insert into table name, in bracket fields names and values. So how to write now? If I want to insert 4th record in assets table,
insert into table.
Either you can write this insert fully capital or else only I capital. Insert into, what is my table name here? What is
asset.
My table? Yes, assets. So that you have to write in double quote. Insert into assets in bracket. You have to write different fields. So in assets table, which all of the fields are there? Only asset ID and comments. So write as it is, don't do the spelling mistake. That you have to write in double quotes. That is asset ID is capital. Asset ID, here use double quote. If the spelling mistake is, tell me. If by mistake I written spelling mistake, tell me. Next you have to write comments in double quotes only. Don't forget to give double quotes. Next, what you have to write? You have to write
values.
Yes. You have to add values. So for asset ID, I want to enter. Suppose if you want to add 4th record, then you just write asset ID 4. If you want to give 5, then you can give 5 also. Give a comma. For this, you have to use single quote for values. Comments. Now, which comment you want to give? better I'll take and close the bracket, just give a semicolon. After writing this, click on this execute. It will show here the status of your query, command successfully executed. By mistake, if I'll not given here double quotes, if I'll execute this, it will gives you the error, that is unexpected token comments in statement insert into assets. So don't do anywhere mistake or else it will gives you the error. Here I forgot to give the same double quotes, so here I'll give double quotes again. I'll execute. What it is showing? Violation of unique constraint SYSPK. Okay, insert into assets, asset ID, comments, values, 5, better. It is correct only. Just I'll execute once again. Okay, I'll see my table name, assets. I'll start writing once again. Insert
well,
into.
Insert,
no, it will not come star. It will come insert into only. As per the syntax, you have to write. And this assets you have to give double quotes. Insert into assets. In bracket, you have to write the field name. So, what is my field name here? One is
asset ID.
Asset ID. Comma, one more is comments. Close the bracket, write values. I want to enter, I'll take here 6, comma, comment I have to give best. Any comment you can give, it is not like that you have to give same thing, give semicolon. Execute. Okay, it is showing command successfully executed. When if it will show command successfully executed, then the answer is correct. Close this, go to your table, refresh it. Okay, to see you just have to refresh this table. So refresh this, you can see here 5th one also it is added and 6th record also it is added. Okay, understood this one, how to insert the record in table with help of insert query?
Yes, ma'am.
Syntax you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
In theory exam, don't write syntax. Write down the query which I executed now. In double quotes, correctly you write capital letters, small letters, you have to write correctly. Okay? You all understood insert query?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
From now, which query?
Next, we will see update query. Okay, so what is the use of update query? So, suppose this is my table. Which one it is? This is my table of assets. In that, I have added 5th and 6th record. Now, from this table, suppose if I want to change something, instead of this good, I want to insert different comment. That time, if I want to change the data from the table, that time I'm going to use update. By the name itself, you will come to know what is the meaning of update. Update means what? To change. If I want to change the record from the table, if I want to change the data from the table, that time I have to use the update query. So what is the use of update query? If you want to change the data in the table, that time we are going to use update query. As you already know the syntax of update query, it is there in your page number 242. See, that is update table name, set column 1 is equal to value 1, column 2 is equal to value 2, where condition. Now, suppose update, my table name is assets, we have to write set as per the syntax. Column 1 means what? This is our first column and this is our second column. So column 1 means what we have to write? If you want to take column 1, we have to write asset ID is equal to which value we have to write? From this, what you want to change, that value we have to write in that value 1. Second, it is telling column 2. That is, this is our column 2, that is comments, which is equal to value 2. Any value we can write which you want to change. Suppose if I want to change from good to best, I have to write this value. And where? Condition. From these two, what we have to change. Suppose if I want to change only from one column, that is only I want to change this comments, that is from good to best, I have to write only comments is equal to good, and where we have to write from that what we have to change. Okay, so to run this query now, we have to click on this tools option. From this we have to select this SQL, and here you have to write the query. So just start writing the query. As you know the syntax, that is update. What is my table name here?
Assets.
So you have to write here assets. After that, what we have to write as per the syntax? You have to write set. Either you can write fully capital or else only first letter capital. So I have written here update assets set. What we have to write? Column 1, which is equal to value 1. As you can see in the table, I want to change this asset ID first from good to, I will write here bad. So which column name you have to choose? You have to choose this comments column name. So how to write this query now here? Update table name set. What we have to write? We have to write that is comments. So what we are going to change here? So from that comments, okay, suppose if I return that column 1, that is comments, I want to change that good comment to bad comment. So directly you have to enter here comments is equal to, you have to write bad. What you want to change, that you are going to write in this value, not that which it is already having. You have to write what you want to change, that value you have to write. Is that clear to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Comments is equal to bad. After that, what we have to write? We have to write where condition. So where it is present that good comment, that we have to see. Okay, so as you can see in your table, it is present in first column. So you have to write where column name, that is asset ID, is equal to 1. What you want to change, you are changing this good. So good is present in which column? That you have to write. It is present in asset ID 1. Okay, so same thing you have to write here. Where it is present? That is asset ID, which is equal to 1. So it will change that good to bad. If I'll execute this query, you all understood how to write this query, why I written this set and why I written this comments only?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt in this?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Okay, no. Just click on this execute. It will show command successfully executed. Close this. Just go to your table, refresh your table. As you can see here, it changes good to bad here. It changed or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so you all understood about the update query. If you want to change something from your table, that time you have to use this update query. Now, suppose if you want to change asset ID from 1 to, if you want to make 100, that also you can do that with the help of this query. So for that, what we have to do? Just click on your tools, SQL. You have to write the query, that is update. Your table name is assets. In double quotes, you have to write. You have to write set, for that S capital. What you are going to do now? You want to change that asset ID from 1 to 2. Okay, so you have to write asset ID, which is equal to, you want to change that from 1 to 100. Okay, so right here, what you want to change? So I want to change that with 100. So I am writing here 100. Next, here write down where that is present. So I have to write where it is present in comment section. Comments, which is equal to bad. Also, you can write ulta. You can give a semicolon. Execute. It is showing command successfully executed. Close it. Go to your table once again. Refresh it. So you can see here, it changes to 100 here. Where your bad is there, from that it is changing to 100. Even it is giving in the ascending order automatically. Understood this one, how to change?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Understood the update query?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Whenever I am doing here practically, you also you have to do in your own system. Until and unless you will not do practically, you will not knowing to know the what is difficulty in that. So whenever I am doing here practically, you have to do in your system. If you don't have system, you have to listen carefully, or else you just go to your friend's home, or else afterwards also you can do. But whenever I am doing here practical, you have to do there if you have the system in your home. Don't sit like that if you'll have the system also. Okay, understood the update query?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next query is, that is last query, delete. Okay, so now what is the use of delete query? If you want to delete the record from the table, if you want to remove that data from the table, you are going to use delete query. The syntax of delete query is what? Delete from table name where condition. Okay, so we will start writing the query. You have to go on tools, SQL. So what is the syntax? That is delete from
star.
Directly write. Yeah, don't write star. It will give you the error. If I'll written star here, it will give you the error. So write directly. Yes? By writing star also, I'll show you that once. Okay, how it will give you the error.
Okay, ma'am.
So here, you have to write delete from table name. So what is my table name here? Table name is assets. So I'll write here assets where condition. It means what? From this table, suppose if you want to delete only this last record, that is 100 record. So what you have to write? We have to write the condition. Condition means we have to take that field name and value. So I have to enter this asset ID and 100. So how to write that now? Delete from assets where, what is my condition? I want to change that 100 record. So where it is present? It is present in asset ID. As you can see here, it is present in asset ID. So you have to write as it is. Asset ID, which is equal to 100. Value you have to write in single quote. Give a semicolon, execute. It will show command successfully executed. Close it. Go to your table once again. Refresh your table. As you can see here, 101 record is not there. It got deleted. Okay. Suppose if I'll give here instead of that, suppose if I'll use star here, that is delete star from assets where
ID
asset ID, which is equal to 3. Give a semicolon, just press execute. As you can see, unexpected token star requires from in statement delete. So it will give you the error, that is unexpected token. So just delete this one. Yes, what happened?
That means only for select query it will come.
Yeah, only for select query the star will come. Because star means what? Whole record we are selecting.
Okay, ma'am.
So delete, cancel this, execute unexpected token asset ID. Okay, I think the spelling is wrong. It is correct only. SSET ID is equal to 3. 3 is not there in table. 3 is there. Why it is giving error? Delete from assets where, okay, where spelling is wrong. Execute. Okay, command successfully executed. Close it. Now just go to your table once again. Refresh it. It is deleting whole record. What I did? Okay. So if you want to delete whole record, you have to write drop command for that. That is drop table, table name. Okay. It deleted the whole record now. Suppose now if you want to delete the whole record, then you have to write the query that is drop command. Drop command is used to delete whole record from the table. So how to write that now? Click on tools, SQL, and write down here drop table. What is your table name now here? Assets. Whatever you created the table, that also it will get deleted. Just give a semicolon, execute, command successfully executed, close it, go to your table once again, refresh it. As you can see here, whatever you have created the data, that whole data it will go, that whole table only it will get deleted. That is the use of drop command. Drop command is used to delete whole record, that is whole table. Understood these all five queries?
Ma'am, without queries also we can do these functions, no?
Without queries also you can do, but it will take more time. Suppose now, if you want to insert 100 record in the table, not only 1 and 2, if you want to insert 100 data in the table, again and again you are going to insert, no, in that table. First you have to insert first record, after that second, after that third, after that fourth, like that 100 record you have to insert again and again. So it will consume, it will take more time to insert the data. But with the help of insert query, if I'll use that 100 record, you can insert at a time. Within 1 minute you can insert after writing the query.
Okay, ma'am.
So that is the use of this query. Instead of means now in Excel sheet how you are entering the data. If I tell you to insert 10,000 of data in Excel sheet, then what you will do? You will see it there. You will enter name and one by one you will enter the names. But with the help of this query, if I want to insert 10,000 record in the table, only I have to write that one line of query, it will take that 10,000 record in that Excel sheet. In Excel sheet, automatically it will get insert that 10,000 records. That is, for that purpose, we are going to use this all queries. Suppose now if you want to delete the all 1,000 of record, you will select and you will delete. I know that one. But if I'll tell you to delete only particular records, that is 5th one, then 6th one, 501, 5021, okay, what you will do? You will select that and again you will delete that one by one. So instead of that, you can use the query to delete that. If you want to change a record from the table, so again you will enter there. Again you will do the changes in that with manually. But if I'll write query to change, then it will automatically change with the help of update query. So for that purpose, I'm going to use this queries.
Okay, ma'am.
Understood these all four queries?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now we will see how to create the forms and reports. Any doubt in creating the queries, executing queries?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Now, how to create the forms? Creating the forms, it is very easy. Just you have to select this. Now here it is, queries is there, like how we created the table from table option, how we created the executed the queries from the queries option, like that we have to select this from option. Okay, forms option. In forms, it will tell us there are two options. One is create form in design view and one more is use wizard to create form. When if I'll use this create form in design view, if I'll click on this, here automatically the data will not fetch. We have to enter the records and we have to insert all this data. So don't use this option. Use the second option, that is use wizard to create form. Just click on this use wizard to create form. As you can see, after clicking there, it will give you the different steps and it will give you the fields which you already created the table. So first field, what it will, first step is what? Field selection. You have to select the field from which you have already created the table. So your table you have to select, that is your assets table. If else created so many tables, that is your assets, customers, employees. You can take any one which table you want to create the reports, sorry, forms. Okay, so now I created only assets table. So I'll select my assets table from here. You have to choose the different fields. I created only these two fields I have entered in my table. So I'll select these two fields. You have to enter here. You have to select. Click on next. Next, your step is set up a server form. If you want to add sub form, if you want to add extra form, one more form, you have to add that sub form. If you want to add, it will ask, decide if you want to set up a sub form. If you want to insert one more form, it will ask you to add. Okay, just have to click on this add sub form. If you want to add one more sub form, just have to add sub form. Just click on next. Again, it will ask you the table name and your fields. This is for sub form. If you want one more form, okay, so you have to select. If you have one more table, just select that one more table. Till now I created only one table, so I'll select that one only. I'll add the fields here. Click on next option. After that, get joined fields. Which all are the fields you want to join combinedly? Okay, from here you have to select this. First, join subform field. First, what you want to select? Here I'll take assets ID and here I'll take comments. Only I want to combine this only one, because in my table I have created only these two fields. If there are more fields, then you can combine that together, like assets ID and comments. If there is one more field is there, you can combine that with assets ID with one more field. Click on next. Here it will ask you arrange controls. Which one you want to take for main form and sub form? You have to select from here which one you want to take. You can take which one you want, which one you want from here. Okay, so click on next. Sets data entry. Now here it will ask, select the data entry mode. Which mode you want to enter? The form is to be used for entering new data. If you want to enter new data in that form, you can select this one. The form is to be display all data which you already inserted the data, which already inserted the records in that same table that you have. If you want that only, then you have to select this option. Or else, if you want to enter new data in that form, you have to select this option. Click on next. Now apply styles. From here, if you want to apply the style for your form, if you want to change the color of your form, you can change the form color. I'll take your orange color. If you want ice blue, you can take ice blue also. If you want gray, you can take which color you want to take. Okay, I'll take your orange. If you want, it is flat. If you want, it is 3D look. If you want no border, you can take, I'll take your 3D look. Click on next. Set name. Already my name is assets. If you want to change the name of this, you can give here your own name. Now my table is assets, so I'll not change my name. I'll give assets only here. How do you want to proceed after creating the form? Okay, if you want to work with that form, if you want to modify the form, in the sense, if it is already there, then you can modify. If you want to work with the form, you can work on it. Just if you want to modify the form, you can modify. Or else if you want to work on that, you can choose that option. Click on finish. As you can see here, whatever the data you have given, your form is ready. As you can see here, if you want to insert now asset ID as 4, you can insert whatever the comments you want to give. You can add the comments here. If you want to add one more asset ID for sub form, you can give one more asset ID. If you want to add a comment, you can add a comments. So this is
the comment.
You can give any comment as I typed this. Anything. I'll give you a good. Okay, you can write any comment, your own comment. If you want to save, you just save from file. You just save this. I think it's already saved.
And something error came on access. What was that?
That was this queries ka. not for this.
Oh, okay.
Okay, if you want to insert the comments here, you can insert the comments. That is the creation of your forms. Like this, too many forms you can create. That is, here I have given in the table only asset ID and comments as two field names. If you want to insert more fields in the table, and if you want to combine that both together fields, then you can add like this forms. You can create the form like this. In HTML, you are creating the forms by creating the table. For that, you are using different language to create the forms. So here, if you'll create the table directly, you can insert create the forms. There is no programming language is needed for this. Understood this one?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt you have?
No.
Now, if you want to save this, you can save. Okay. This is about creation of forms. So everyone understood how to create the forms?
Yes, ma'am.
Next is creating the reports. Here, there is no need to create the reports. After creating the forms, automatically it will give you the report. Only just you have to enter field names and table name. Okay, so to create the reports, click on this reports. Click on use wizard to create report. After clicking, it will ask you to fill the steps and table name. So in field selection, you have to give your table name. Here you have to add your different fields. Next step, labeling fields. Okay. So if you want to change this labeling fields, field names, if you want to change, you can change here. If you don't want to change, click on next. Grouping. What you want to do grouping, which all are the fields? You have to write that one. So here I have given only two field names. So I'll give only two fields to group. Sort portion. If you want to sort something, either ascending or descending order. I want that comments in descending order, so I'll take this in descending. Click on next. Choose layout. What you want from here? Okay, what you want to change? You have to give the styles for that. Change it. If you want landscape or else portrait, you can select from here orientation. I'll take landscape only. If you want to take a layout of headers and footers, you can take the styles from here. Click on next. Now create report. It will ask the title of report, what you want to give. As the table is assets, so I'll give here title as assets only. If you want that in static report or dynamic report. Static means it will be not getting changed. It will be as it is. Dynamic means it will be getting changed. If you want to modify that report layout, you can modify. Or else if you want to create that report now, you can create it. If you want to make a changes in that, you have to select this modify option. If you don't want to do a modification and all, you want to directly create, then you just have to select this create report now. Click on finish. After doing this, your report will get ready. As you can see here, whatever the fields are given. Okay, whatever the fields are given, that report, it is getting ready here. And you can see that in your reports here, assets report is present here. If I'll go in forms, your form is ready here. You can take that one. If you want print of this, you can take the print. Understood this, how to create the forms and reports?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt you have now?
No.
This got finished your unit 3. Okay, in the next class, I'll complete unit 2, that is last session, recording macro, run macro, and with the help of star basic program, I'll execute that one. Any doubt you have in this creation of table, creation of queries, creating of forms and reports? Anyone is having any doubt?
No.
Understood everything?
Yes.
You have to do this practically, not only theory, listening and going. You have to sit alone and you have to do this practically in your computer. Until and unless you will not do practically, you will not come to know your doubts. So you have to do this practically. Is that clear to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, bye-bye. Take care.